We know that we have learned that momentum or linear momentum is a physical quantity which explains how much kinetic energy it can transfer when there is a collision between the bodies, which is mathematically defined as product of mass and velocity, and it's a vector quantity. There is a concept called law of conservation of linear momentum, which tells you that if there is no external force acting on a system, then you can say, we know the formula, actually we have learned the Newton's law, Fs according to Newton's second law is defined as rate of change of momentum. If this F equal to 0, I can write rate of change of momentum is also 0. I can further write change in the momentum equal to 0 into time, that is 0. So I have proved that change in momentum is 0. It tells you that when the change in the momentum is 0, it tells you that momentum is constant. This law is called law of conservation of linear momentum, which tells you that if there is no external force acting on a system, momentum of a system is a constant. And of course, I have proved it just now, basing on the Newton's second law, which defines force as rate of change of momentum. So according to law of conservation of linear momentum, if there is no external forces acting on a system, the momentum of the system always remains a constant. It's very simple and easy to understand. Say for example, we would like to apply this law of conservation of linear momentum and see what is the consequences of using a simple example like recoiling of gun. You might have probably seen this in many scenarios, like whenever a bullet is fired from a gun, it is noticed that the gun comes backward. That's called something like recoiling of the gun. Let's assume this is like a gun where you are firing a bullet. Bullet is moving forward with a velocity v. What happens in this case? We want to understand. We know initially both bullet and gun are in the state of rest. Is it not? Initially gun and bullet are at rest. That means they are having a zero velocities. So I can write P initial of the bullet plus P initial of the gun, but mass of the bullet, velocity of the bullet is zero. Mass of the gun, velocity of the gun is also zero. So initial momentum is zero. And there is no serious external force acting on the system. Therefore, as according to linear conservation, law of conservation of frictional is zero, I can write P initial equal to P final. So P initial is zero. P final is P final of the bullet as well as P final of the gun. So I can say momentum of the gun final is minus momentum of the bullet final. So mass of the gun, say for example capital V, velocity of the gun is also capital M and capital V, mass of the bullet is small m, let the velocity of the bullet is something like V bullet. Basing on this, we can calculate what is the recoil velocity of the gun is as minus mass of the bullet, velocity of the bullet by mass of the gun. So it's very clear that as mass of the gun is always much bigger than the mass of the bullet, velocity of the gun will be, recoiling velocity of the gun is much less than that of the velocity of the bullet. So here we are just taking into consideration law of conservation of linear momentum. This is what we need to explain in this post. Thank you.